the first treatment for dyslipidemia is obviously physical activity. You activate your lipoprotein lipase, which is the best enzyme to catch lipids from the blood. to measure the guidelines, there is a difference between the AHA and the ESC guidelines. The ACC and the AHA guidelines do not precise a target for cholesterol. They have several level. Sorry. They have several level to consider the intensity of treatment, but they do not target cholesterol level. Instead, the ESA has a cholesterol target. It has several charts, low risk and high risk charts that you know very well. These charts are high risk or low risk according to the country where you use the chart. And you have a classification of very high risk, moderate risk, or low risk. When you get the score, the risk level, you have a very clear chart with a target for LDL-C, cholesterol. You see, with the very low level risk, you can have a very high level of cholesterol without asking intervention. With the medium level, you consider to be 100 milligram per deciliter, then 70 for the high risk, and for the very high risk, your cholesterol is never low enough. The medication which is preferred is statins, and this Cochrane review is very interesting because it shows you that for each decrease of 1 millimole per liter, the incidence of stroke decreased by 22%. That was in primary prevention. In secondary prevention, you have also a very nice power of statins. You can add ezetimibe and eventually PCKS9 inhibitors. Here you have a hazard ratio, which is very interesting after 6 years of intervention. The overall protection has been checked in CTT cholesterol treatment trialist, and in any case, per 1 millimole per liter reduction of HDL cholesterol, you get a decrease in coronary events, in coronary revascularization, and interestingly, in ischemic stroke as well. You have also to consider triglycerides and the target value usually used in a clinical setting is 2.7 millimole per liter, and statins are a strong treatment for triglycerides. Don't forget the HDL cholesterol, which is very difficult to treat. And again, physical activity is very important to activate your lipoprotein lipase. Lipoprotein lipase is able to pick up the cholesterol which comes from the small intestine to the liver, as well as the cholesterol traveling from the liver to the liver or other organs. And only today, physical activity can activate the lipoprotein lipase. Specific population will need specific attention as the established CVD, metabolic syndrome, the target is to decrease LDL-C at least of 50%. Statins in ACS may need an initial high dose before the procedure if you have an elective PCI. There is no indication for heart failure or autoimmune disease. And as you know, chronic kidney disease is often associated with high-risk cardiovascular disease and need a lot of treatment. You have the choice of statin. There are two very strong statins, atorvastatin and rosuvastatin. You see that there is a dependence on the drug and on the dose. The future may be in the treatment of CPK, PCSK9. A vaccine has been tried. The cholesterol is down 50%, but there is some drawbacks as the pain at the site of injection. Instead, interfering RNA, which interfere with the RNA of PCKS9, can be given to high-risk patients with a very important decrease and a very long-term effect, since after 9 months of follow-up, the decrease is still 50% in this population. As you can see, the recommendations in case of very high risk condition of high risk cardiovascular risk of other manifestation of CVD in primary prevention and of course in secondary prevention are 1A, 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 and 1A. This treatment is very cost effective. Each stroke in Europe is around 70,000 euro each. That's 45 billion a year, and each hour it's 5 million euro. Here you see the place of cholesterol on a cost effective, which is disability adjusted life years. And very interestingly, statin was particularly developed for heart diseases, and you have here the relative risk ratio for heart diseases, considering a decrease of cholesterol more than 50% or less than 50%. And in the brain, you have exactly the same benefit. So I think that statins are a very powerful treatment to prevent stroke. Thank you very much.
Thank you for an excellent presentation. There's time for one question. If there's no question, I have one question. You clearly made a point for statins, but you also mentioned first thing is physical activity. Can you recommend a type of physical activity? Is it moderate activity, or there's a lot of discussion going on? What do you say to your patients?
To the patient, we say that walking 15 minutes a day is enough. You get already about 20 to 30% of the gain that you would have if you were an Olympic runner. So it's very easy for people to increase their physical activity.